shares the word of God.
Ngami mana yacu mu izina rya Yesu tugushimiye ibyiza wadukoreye tugushimiye kuri Imana tugushimiye ubuntu bwa kubuzima bwacu kuri Omega Church by'umwihariko uyu munsi mwami twakiriye umukozi wawe umuja wawe mwami Catherine turagusaba mwami Yesu Kristo ngo ubuntu bwawe ibyo wamwigishije ibyo wamuhaye ayo mavuta tugereho ubwo buntu butugereho mwami Yesu Kristo ntategwe nagira ikimukanga abivuge nk'uko bisuka muri we icyubahiro nikuzo tubishuje wowe twakira ijambo ryawe mu izina rya Yesu uvuga ngo amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Clap your hand for the woman of God as she's going to sit in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm so honored. I'm so humbled. For to see this big team waiting for me. Uwiteka abampera umugisha.
May God bless
Hallelujah.
You.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Urakoze Yesu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Urakoze mwami.
Lord, take all the glory.
Ufatikwikiwahiro cyose.
And take all adoration.
Ukwiye gushirwa hejuru.
And be magnified in our life.
Ushirwe hejuru mu buzima
bwacu. In this small moment you are going to speak your holy name.
Murakanya gato tugiye kuvuga.
In Jesus name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 I will not speak many things. But I will not manage to speak it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
No, no, I will not manage to speak them.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I honor the angel of this house. The woman God has chosen in this generation to lead this great men and women of God. Please help me. Clap your hand to honor the woman of God.
Pastor
Lilios, I honor you, Mama. I honor the father of the house if he's here.
Hallelujah.
I didn't
know you. I'm sorry.
Please help me to honor the father of this house as the man God has said. Hallelujah. To honor the woman of God. Papa, I honor you. Thank you for allowing this woman to preach the gospel of Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Many men you find they become an obstacle to the women when they are called as a set men. You know, in kingdom we are also called the men of God. Hallelujah.
There is no gender
in kingdom. But we thank God you have honored your wife. And God will honor you ever. Hallelujah. My prayer, live longer like how Moses lived. More than 120
in life.
Hallelujah. I thank God for all the leadership of this ministry. May God honor you. And may God give you strength to serve him diligently. The reward is in heaven. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So we are going straight to the word of God. I came with my beloved sister. I came with my beloved sister, the woman God has raised in this generation. She is my sister-in-law. She is my sister-in-law.
But I call
her my sister in love. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's a wife of a senior pastor in Myumbu Parish Restoration Church.
And she's the wife of my brother.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's a place I was ministering just in a few minutes ago. May God bless you. She's a great singer. I could give you just hear her voice, but there's no time. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you for coming with me, my sister. Glory to God. So we are going to the message. I pray that you will show me when the time just here. And I will try to summarize what God has prepared for you. Hallelujah. The woman of God told me that you've been speaking in the Bible study different things, different spheres. And when we had a chat night, I think one day ago or 2 days ago. And she told me, you are the light person. I was just giving her a small testimony on what God is doing in my life. For the assignment God has given me. Hallelujah. So she requested me to speak. What does Bible say about a Christian in politics? That's what I can say.
Icyo Bibiliya ivuga ku Mukristo ukora politike.
Yes, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. What is politics?
Politike ni iki?
Is the set of activities that are associated with the governance of a country, a state,
Leta,
or area. Hallelujah. And then I love another one. I will jump many of them. I had many definitions. And then the other one says politics is a noble activities. Noble activities. In which men decides the rules they will live by in the certain goals. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. In a simple way, the way I say it, politics is a man-made systems.
Hallelujah.
To rule or govern the society or the nations God has given them. So politics is from God.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Politics is from God. Hallelujah. You shouldn't see politician and you feel that people maybe not people of God. They are also children of God. Hallelujah. In the Bible we have many political heroes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Who served God and served their nations with all their heart. Yet they are still strong in Christian's life. In Old Testament we have many men and women of God who served God as politicians. Served God in kingdom and also in political arena. Hallelujah.
So
I will not manage to read all the scriptures. You will just write them. And Mama will give you many of them. So we have
Joseph
in Genesis chapter 41. If you want to understand the life of Joseph, lead Joseph from chapter 37 to 43. Hallelujah. And we have a great man of God, King David. He was a great king and he was a servant of God. In 1 Chronicles chapter 18 verse 14, and then you go chapter 14 verse 17 and you go on. We have his son King Solomon. Hallelujah. He was a great leader, a wise leader, the leader of the nation. But he was a great servant of God. This is the man, he could go down and lie down and cry to him. He did overnights like how we do overnights. Remember the time he was chosen to be a king of
Israel.
He went and spent time with God. Hallelujah. And lie down. Maybe he was on the carpet like how sometimes we do it. And cried to him. Hallelujah. So it means he was an intercessor. I want just to make it simple so that you can understand that he was a king. He was ordained to be a king. He was chosen to be a king, to be a president of the nation. But he went back to ask, to request from God, Father, I can't be able to lead these people. Please tell me, what should I do? And he requested the main thing. He wanted wisdom. He asked God, I need wisdom and a discernment spirit how I can lead these people. Do we have men and women of God who are chosen to lead in this nation, and then they go back to God and say, Father, hallelujah, I was not deserving this position, but give me wisdom and discernment spirit because I'm going to another arena. to another mountain. I love how you say umusozi wa politiki. Hallelujah. It's another mountain. You are in the mountain of kingdom, but you are going to the mount of politics. What do you ask God? Hallelujah. Glory to God. That's the man God used him mightly. In 1 Kings chapter 3, you will read what I was talking from verse 1 to 13. And then also
1
Kings chapter 4, verse 27 to 30. This is how God was answering him to what he's going to become. We have other great men of God like Nehemiah. He served the kingdom in the kingdom, I can say the kingdom of darkness, like in a place where they don't know God, they don't honor God. But this man, he didn't lose his identity. He even remembered that he needed to go back and fix some things in his nation. When God promoted him, when God gave him money, when he became rich, everything, he didn't forget his nation. He remembered he needed to go and fix something. So when God will raise you in this ministry and make you somebody in this nation, please don't forget this ministry. Hallelujah. Don't become big for this ministry. Bring those treasures. Bring that money. Hallelujah. And expand the Omega ministry. Glory to God. That's what Nehemiah did. Glory to God. We have another great man which I will speak just in a few minutes. We had a great man, Daniel. Hallelujah. This was a politician man. He served four kings. Glory to God. He served four presidents. And them, they were not using a short term like how we do now. They could read for some years. Hallelujah. But this young man, because of the spirit of excellence upon his life, he served four kings. He served four kings. He didn't only serve Babylons. He also said he served in Persia, the kingdom of Persia. I think he was an advisor, or he could solve many things in the kingdom of Persia. This was a politician man. You know, people who serve like governors, these are the people who are serving in kingdom, in a government. Work hard. When you see a result in the nation, governors worked hard. Hallelujah. So this man was a governor, and he was advisors of presidents for four kingdoms. Hallelujah. This is a man who served God, who feared him, who was praying more than any other man who can pray in this nation. Hallelujah. I always desire to pray like Daniel. Because he was praying like Muslims, I think. Because at least they follow their duties and their responsibility, and they do it better than Christians. This man could pray three times a day. Do we do it? Hallelujah. And he could take time. And he didn't hide. Hallelujah. And he was doing it with excellence. We need leaders who can do that. Who can get a chance to serve God in politics. And they continue serving God with excellence. Hallelujah. This is a man who was serving with excellence. He's a man who believed God, who believed everything, who believed his culture. He never lost his identity. If you can lead, just you lead yourself in the book of Daniel, chapter 1, to understand the life of Daniel from chapter 1, I think you can lead from chapter 1, verse 1 to 17.
mushobora gutangira ku murongo wa mbere gice cya mbere cya Daniel kujya ku murongo wa
17-21 you will hear who is Daniel
umurongo wa 17-21 muzumva Daniel uwari we
and you go chapter 2
mugere ku gice cya kabiri
you will lead yourself from verse 14 to 23
muhere ku murongo wa 17-23
and you also will lead 46 until the end
hallelujah
when you read the book of Daniel you will be changed transformed
uzahindurwa
I would require I would request hallelujah and recommend if you are here in this ministry and you have the desire to read hallelujah read the book of Daniel and read the book of Proverbs you will never be small in the leadership hallelujah you will have wisdom you will have the word to answer in every question comes across to you
and
you will always open your mouth with wisdom
please
these are great role models
that's why
you hear King Solomon was a great man of God and a great leader in his leadership time
he was rich
he was excellent in, he had wisdom hallelujah and he was a great leader but also he had a wisdom of God hallelujah he was a servant of God if you go to the book of Proverbs or you go back to the books of the Chronicles the book of Chronicles or the first king and second king you will hear many scenarios King Solomon had to solve in the high wisdom of God hallelujah so I recommend you read the book of Proverbs and the book of Daniel if you want to be a great
leader
we have great women of God hallelujah we have Deborah we have many of them we have Miriam we have many women of God we have Ruth we have
Esther
we have many women of God hallelujah not only in the Old Testament even in the New Testament you have women who served Jesus and they served him with excellence they were leading churches hallelujah we have Phoebe hallelujah I do speak to people who says women can't have church can't lead them in the ministry
but
Phoebe was leading a church hallelujah even if he was not called a pastor hallelujah but he was a leader of a ministry and he served with wisdom so we have many great men and women of God in the Bible I can speak them and more in the Bible we have more than 100 scriptures speaking politics. Let's read hallelujah, glory to God. God's purpose for any government is in two broad areas. God appoints government, the first one. God appoints government leaders to promote justice for everyone. That's why you have to know that the politics is from God. God appoints government leaders to promote justice for everyone. Imagine if you are among of the people appointed in a government and you know God. You now fulfill the will of God in double portion. Hallelujah. In Romans chapter 13, if they can lead for us, or can put in, then we read. You can read in Kinyarwanda.
Hallelujah.
And read both of them. Romans chapter 13, verse 1 to 4. And then 1 Peter chapter 2, 13 to 16.
Abaroma gice cya 13 umurongo wa mbere kugera kwa kane haravuga ngo umuntu wese agandukire abatware bamutwara
hallelujah
kuko ari nta butware butava ku mana
glory to god
n'abatware bariho bose bashyizweho n'Imana
hallelujah
nicyo gituma ugandira umutware aba yanze itegeko ry'Imana kandi abaryanga bazatsindwa n'urubanza
hallelujah
abatware sabo gutinywa n'abakora ibyiza keretse abakora nabi mbese ushaka kudatinya umutware
yes lord
kora neza nawe azagushima
glory loyal to God.
Kuko ari umukozi w'Imana uguhesha ibyiza.
Amen.
Ariko nukora nabi utinye.
Imana imwita umukozi w'Imana.
God calls him a servant of God.
Umuntu ukora muri politiki.
Someone who serves in politics.
Imana ikamwita umukozi w'Imana.
God calls them a servant of God.
Hallelujah. Komeza.
Kuko ari umukozi w'Imana uguhesha ibyiza.
Hallelujah.
Ariko nukora nabi utinye. Kuko adatwarira inkota ubusa.
Glory to God.
Numukozi w'Imana uhoresha umujinya ukora nabi.
Thank you Lord. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 13.
Petero wa mbere igice cya kabiri umurongo wa 13.
Thank you Jesus. Thank you Lord.
Petero wa mbere igice cya kabiri umurongo wa 13. Mugandukire aba ubutware bwose bw'abantu kubwo umwami wacu.
Yes Lord.
Naho yaba umwami kuko ari we usumba bose. Cyangwa abatware kuko ari bo batumwe nawe guhana inkozi z'ibibi no gushima abakora neza.
Thank you Lord.
Umurongo 15 kuko ibyo Imana ishaka ari uko mujibisha abantu babapfapfa batagira icyo bamenya gukora neza kwanyu.
Yes Lord. And then 16, yes.
Mumeze nka umudendezo koko ariko uwo mudendezo mutawutwikiriza ibibi ahubwo mugenze nk'imbata z'Imana.
Hallelujah, glory to God.
Amen.
Abona politiki, those are politicians, God was speaking to them.
Abona abanya politiki Imana yarimo kuvuga.
God does this. Hallelujah.
Imana ibijyonga ibyibikorera
to protect the law abiding citizens,
kugira ngo irinde abantu bagendera ku mategeko.
Hallelujah.
Ahane abatagendera ku mategeko.
God puts politicians,
Imana ishyiraho abanya politiki
to protect those who obey laws,
kugira ngo irinde babandi bagendera ku mategeko,
and also to punish those who break laws,
no guhana abatumvira amategeko.
Glory to God. The second point,
impamvu ya kabiri,
God appoints government leaders,
Imana ishyiraho abayobozi ba politiki,
to promote peace and order in the society,
kugira ngo ishyigikire amahoro n'umutuzo cyangwa se kugendera ku murongo muri sosiyete.
So those are important people.
Aba ni abantu bakomeye cyane.
And you should desire to read if you have reader that talent in your life.
Ukwiye kugira icyifuzo cyo kuyobora niba ufite iyo mpano.
So the last scripture, I'm going to just read the last one.
First Timothy chapter 2.
So you should, if you are a servant of God, you are a child of God, and you really desire to read, you have double portion. Because this is what you are going to do. You are going to promote peace and order in the nation.
Niba ufite impano y'ubuyobozi ukwiye kwifuza kuyobora, kuko nubikora uzaba urimo kuza ubushake bw'Imana mu buryo bwose, uzaba ushyigikiye amahoro no kugira sosiyete igendera ku murongo.
Hallelujah. Let him lead 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 1 to 2.
Timoteyo wa mbere igice cya kabiri umurongo wa mbere n'uwa kabiri aravuga ngo irya mbere ya byose ndaguhugurira kwingingira abantu bose no kubasengera no kubasabira no kubashimira, ariko cyane cyane abami n'abatware bose, kugira ngo duhore mu mahoro tutabona ibyago, twubaha Imana kandi twitonda rwose.
Yes Lord. Thank you Jesus. Those are the things we need as the children of God.
Ibyo byo bintu dukeneye nk'abana b'Imana.
We have to be leaders.
Dukwiye kuba abayobozi.
And honor leaders.
Kandi tukubaha abayobozi.
Them among us, our assignment is not to break them. Hallelujah. It's not to discourage them, but to pray for them, to reverence them, to honor them. Hallelujah. And you will make them lead well in the nation. In Daniel chapter 4 verse 17, you lead yourself. You will see great men, the men God has prepared to read. Politics is the method or the tool God uses here in the earth to accomplish His will in humankind.
Politike ni igikoresha Imana ikoresha kugira ngo isohoze ubushake bwayo mu isi.
So we should desire to read the nation.
Kwifuza kuyobora
igihugu. The people God desire to read. Hallelujah.
Nk'abana Imana yifuza ko bayobora.
You will lead yourself in this Bible verses.
Muraza gusoma iyi mirongo yo muri Bibiliya
ni mukubaha. We are the workmanship. Who help God to fulfill His will in this earth. In Ephesians chapter 2 verse 10. And in Galatians chapter 6 verse 10. Glory to God. So I'm going for the time's sake. I'm
going to
jump many things. Maybe God is something I can preach. Maybe I can speak for 1 hour or 1 hour and a half. Maybe one day God will prepare a way for me to speak this and upload.
Hallelujah.
So we should desire to serve God. Like how Daniel served God. And what made him to serve God? And serve the kingdom of the earth. Or serve in politics. It's because he didn't lose his identity. So if you want to be a great leader and you remain you stand well in your Christian life, you should make sure you don't lose your identity. You should not hide that you are a born again Christian. You should make sure those who see you see the identity of God in you.
You
didn't lose only identity. He stood in the principles of God. Even in his temptations, he stood in the principles of God. He didn't leave, he didn't stop to go to pray because he was tempted. Actually, he went to pray more. Hallelujah. That's what is required for a child of God if you are in a politics. When you are tested, you shut your mouth. Hallelujah. You don't go to speak like how other people are speaking. You
can
consult your maker. Hallelujah. And he will go and speak on your behalf. Glory to God. That's what we need as the children of God. So you have to kill your flesh. You have to kill the eyes, your eyes. You have to make sure the lust of your flesh is subject to God. You have to kill the lust of your life, the pride of your life, to be subjected to God. And God will exalt you in everything you do in your life. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many minutes do I left with? Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. So serving in politics is a great thing. And this is a prayer of many servants of God. Especially this nation. God has spoken to many great men and women of God. I'm privileged to be, I was still young. But when they were still abarinzibinkike, you remember? When they were rising, the great men of God were interceding for the nation. So calling them abarinzibinkike. I could go and pray with them. I was young, I was already, I think, I finished just high school. And I would go and kneel down with these great men and women of God. Like those servants of God, like Safari and the other men of God. And I would kneel down, they would kneel 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. And I was like, Lord, why did I come here? The men who were kneeling down for more than 6-7 hours praying for this nation. And they had many prophecies for this nation. And among them, God said he will raise men and women of God who fear God to lead in this nation.
So if
God is speaking in your, heart, that you should be a leader in this nation, please don't hide yourself. Pastor, encourage your sons to read in this nation. Because this among of the prophecies God spoke to this nation. So we need God fearing men and women of God to read in the nation. Hallelujah. When we have great men and women of God leading in the nation, it creates peace in the nation. And also it activates the great justice in the nation. Hallelujah. And many resolutions you find comes and obeying, connecting with God's principles. Hallelujah. So you are the answer of the servant of God who prayed. Hallelujah. So you should desire, young men, desire to read. Hallelujah. You will never backslide if you read. When you read fearing God. Except this is the word of God says in Psalms 25:3.
That
it will never be so. Hallelujah. I'm just paraphrasing. It will never be so. You will never be put to shame. Except yourself, you decide to do it. Hallelujah. So if you stand in the principles of God, God will never disappoint you. Every circumstances, every challenge, every situation, God will give you an answer in that situation if you honor Him. So I'm going to speak my testimony. I'm
going
to just jump everything and speak my testimony. I'm not telling you this because I just led from the Bible all who have done all those works. I've experienced it. I have lived in it, and I continue to grow in Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So my name, as she said, I'm Catherine Muhimundu Mwesije. My second name is Muhimundu. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm married. Hallelujah. We are blessed with four children. My firstborn is taller than me. Hallelujah. We live in South Africa in Cape Town. Hallelujah. So from my childhood, I started as a leader. I don't know how I can
say.
I was leading. I remember the first time. Let me tell you this, because just the Holy Spirit reminded me this. The way I started to become a leader. I was born in
Tanzania.
I grew up there. I did the whole primary school in Tanzania. So when I decided to go to school when I was very young. And in
Tanzania,
if you are not able to touch your ear like this, they don't allow you to go to school. So I was very young. I think I was 5 years and a half or 6 years. But I knew to read and write because I was studying with my elder brothers.
So
I went to school. I followed my brother going to school. Actually, I left home without them knowing. I followed my brother and
the
and I went and I told the teacher that I want to go to school. And they took me in the office and they asked me, you're still, so I should touch the hand there. And I couldn't manage to touch
there.
And I said, but I know to read and write. What do you want me to do to put the hand
here?
And they gave me test and I passed the test, so they allowed me to
manage.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So when I was in grade 2, like primary 2, one day I went to the office. I was chosen as a monitor.
I was a monitor.
You remember how they choose 1 week monitor? So I was the person just to stand, make order in a class in one week.
So
that day I took the papers. The teacher gave me something to take in the office. And I took in the office. And then another teacher gave me something to take to the principal in his office.
God can make
a way when He just wants you. He can do something. And I took the papers in the office of principal. I think he needed to sign something so that I bring back to the office of teachers. And when he was signing, I saw his table is just too much books and everything. His table was just hallelujah. And I started to put everything in order in his table. Take the books, I put everything. And when he's signing, reading what I'm saying, he find everything I've made it in order in his table. And he looked at me and said, wow, what a young girl. You are a great leader. Hallelujah. You made this in my table. Are you willing to be coming and do this every week? And I said, yes, from today I will be coming and do that. That's how I started my leadership. Hallelujah. I started to serve a principal when I'm 7 years old. Hallelujah. From there, I was just a leader. I was a monitor in a class. In Form 4, Primary 4,
P4,
hallelujah. I was chosen to be a klanja wa I think I need to say it in Swahili. Klanja wa usafi. We was since Gisuku. Klanja is like a prefect. Hallelujah. I was a very clean girl. You were very, very deep in a village. But I remember they bought a pass because of me.
hanyuma tugurira ipasi kubera njyewe
because we are wearing skirts which has amarinda you know
kwari dufite amajipo amakanda afite
and I could make sure amarinda yanjye ntavaho ku ijipo yanjye hallelujah
and I would make sure that I iron very well
as young I am I could walk we could walk long distance
nubwo nari mutoya nagendaga urugendo rurerure cyane
I could go with a small clothes I think some people she doesn't even know and I put it in a bag a school bag
kaga shira mwe mwe
so when I reach at school
kujya ngo ningera ku ishuri
I have to wipe my shoes
mbaze mara kuri inkweto zanjye
they could say that there's only one girl here you can't see a dust in her shoes
bakavuga ngo hari umukobwa wenyine muri iki kigo utayugira umukungu ku nkweto ze
that's how they chose me to be a clanja w'isuku hallelujah
kandi kabangize umuyobozi ushinzwe isuku
and when I reached form 5
ngeze mu gatanu
P5
ngeze mu gatanu
I was assistant head girl
umuyobozi wungirije w'abakobwa
and no P6 when I reached P6
ngeze mu gatandatu
because we go to P7 in Tanzania so in P6 I was assistant head girl
mu gatandatu nibwo nabaye wungirije umuyobozi w'abakobwa
head girl hallelujah
I was very young I think I was
13 years old and I came here in Rwanda
mbona kuza mu Rwanda
we came after 1994
kwaje nyuma 1994
and I started at Risedo Kigali
njya kwiga muri Risedo Kigali
everything I could do in my life
ibintu byose nakoraga mu buzima bwanje
I'm saying this as you should check what happens in your life
ndabivuga kugira ngo nawe wireme mu buzima bwawe urebe ibyo biba mu buzima bwawe
like to do
ibintu ukunda gukora
the things you are needed to do in this nation hallelujah I was so much in order
nari mfite nari ku murongo cyane
when I'm in a boarding school when I come back home
kuriye nabaga nagiye ku ishuri nkabayo nkagaruka mu kiruhuko
when mommy knows that I'm going to come back
yo mama wanje yabaga ziko ngiye kugaruka
she told me herself
yaranyibwiriraga
ubwe everyone the family they knew
kandi buri muntu muri famiye yarabizi
she makes sure that she puts everything in order so that I don't fight in the house hallelujah
ngo ibintu byose mubishyire ku murongo kugira ngo ataza agasanga bijagaraye
if I could come back when I come back home
yarabaga namvuye ku ishuri nkagaruka mu rugo
they know everything should change in the house
ibintu byose byarahindukaga
and that leadership followed me
ubwo buyobozi buramurikirana
in Risedo Kigali
muri lise
I started to read when I'm in form 3
natangiye kwibara niga mu gatatu
I was serving my nation things I can't explain deeply
natangiye gukora
In form 4 I also senior 4 I started also reading in the people who are looking like how can I say abareba imyitwarire y'abanyeshuri discipline thank you the word came I was reading discipline at school
ngeze mu wakane umuyobozi ushinzwe
discipline Risedo Kigali is a very big school
kandi Risedo Kigali kigo kinini cyane
we had two sections anglophone and francophone
twagiraga abongereza abavuga icyongereza n'abavuga igifaransa
so much in detail that I know every student
ariko nari nzi buri munyeshuri wese
I could know everyone
nari nzi buri wese
and everything they are doing
nibyo barimo bakora
so they could fear me
baraninyaga
but also love me because I was a loving
I was a loving person.
Everyone could feel to come and confide himself or herself to me.
Abantu benshi bifuzaga kugira ngo baze bangereze ambwira amabanga yabo.
But also when you want to come to me you have to be in order. Hallelujah.
I will correct you.
But I will never let you remain the same. Hallelujah. That's how the leadership followed me. And then I think when I was in form 4 going to form 5 I received Christ. I was a person who loved God from my childhood.
Nakundaga Imana kuva ndi mutoya mu itorero ry'Abangilikani.
No, Lutheran Church.
Mu itorero
I remember I served God when we still in Tanzania very young. Serving priests. You know when you go with candles in front of priests. Hallelujah. So I was a holy girl.
So nyiri mutoya tukiri muri Tanzania nabwo nakoreraga Imana ko kundi aba bana batoya batwara amabuji.
Abahereza ni barabahereza Bible na bujine everything glory to God so when I reached from 5
ngeze mu gatanu
I gave my life to Christ
na hawe buzima bwanjye
Kristo I thank God because God catched me in everything because I was very like nari umuriro n'agakobwa k'umuriro
ndashimira Imana cyane ko yasimfata kubera ko tujye nari umukobwa w'umuriro
nabo ninya kubivuga abakobwa beza munyumve
ahora mbi afraid to say this ubwiza
ushobora kubikoresha mu bintu byiza kandi bikakugirira akamaro hallelujah
Also, the
beauty of God was speaking in my life. Hallelujah.
Baranshakaga
benshi cyane ndi umwana.
There were many people looking for me while I was still young.
But God catched me.
Arikima niramfata.
So that he can keep me to set me apart to serve him.
Kugira ngo ndinde kandi insirire ku ruhande kuzayikorera.
I did a real U-turn.
Narahindukiye byanyabyo.
And then God, he catched me. I was not born again. Ntabwo hamye ngira mami bwo kuvuga ngo nanyuze muri ibi. Njya mivugana abantu bakavuga ngo niki. Ntabwo hamye ngira byo kuvuga ngo nahunze ibyaha. Uzi ko nakijijwe? Can I say it in Kinyarwanda, I think? Muranyumva mwese? Maybe to get time. Maybe uhamye yombwiriza biranane ariko uhamye nashura kubivuga nishyira mu cyongereza ndabyibuka. I went to receive Christ nagiye gukizwa nta kintu nishinza kuko nangaga barokore kubakora amafuti ku ishuri. Babaga ari abanyamafuti nkababona mu mafuti kuko nanabagenzuraga. So nkababona amafuti nkavuga agenda ajya gukizwa iki. Icyo gihe sinabonye Lutheran Church ariko najyaga muri Anglican Church. And I was very straightforward in everything. Sasa umunsi umwe kugira ngo nkizwe Imana ko yari nzi ko ishaka mu bintu byinshi byayo, I went with one girl, umukobwa wa Musoni Protas. That's my friend, you remember, a minister wa IT. She's twararyamanye, twarabanye 6 years in Sedo Kigali. So she told me, ndashaka kugutwara ujye kureba umugore ufite principles nk'izawe, Pastor Christina Gatabazi. I was very young, but people could see me with to the big people. Bandebaga mu bantu bakomeye. Ambye turiya mugore atarasana anti wawe kandi numuntu uri principal ati numuntu nyine ukuntu meze ni kumeze. So aranyinginganya ngo amaze nk'amezi atatu anatanu buri gihe ufite umuntu uzagutwara ku mwami Yesu. Ndemera arantwara ngiye the good thing that day Pastor Christine was preaching. And I sat down. Shaka umugayo kuri uriya mugore ndamubura. That's what God need to see you. Aho umuntu ashaka umugayo kuri wowe akawubura. Glory to God. Amen. And she preached. I saw excellence. I saw precision. I saw what she's speaking, the word of God. Yari yigishije Bible study. Since niba nigishije nabwirije, I don't know. Ariko yari mu yigisha Bible study. And after the Bible study, and she preached again. I loved the woman. Agiye guhamagara abakizwa. I don't know how I went. Ariko umva ijambo ryatumye nkizwa. He said, ushobora kubukora neza uri umugwaneza uri umukiranutsi mu bintu byose ukiranikamo witwararika buri kintu ariko utakiriye Yesu nk'umwami n'umukiza wawe ntabwo uzabona ijuru ngo imirimo myiza wakoze yose hano ku isi kandi nakoraga imirimo myiza urumva nari umuntu ushaka gukora imirimo myiza nanavuga ngo imirimo yose myiza wakoze ngo ishobora gukurwaho nonaha igahabwa ubwo nari nkicaye ngo igahabwa uje kwakira agakiza uno munsi ngo ugapfa nta kintu ufite ukajya ikuzimu ndavuga ye yewe kubaho kwanjye kose neza no kwirinda igihe cyose mbura ijuru nuko nahagurutse njya gukizwa haleluya ariko nkijijwe kandi nsanga ko hari ibyo ntarinze kuko kenshi when you don't know God sometimes you think you are perfect but you do mistake every moment. Glory to God. So that time I received Christ. And from there I was leading with excellency but also honoring God in everything. And I became an intercessor. So in form 5 and form 6 I was serving God. And I was still serving my nation. Me, I was not only serving at school. I was also serving my nation. Hallelujah. So I finished my school. I got married. And God did, because God always directs you everywhere I was reading. I can't just manage to tell you all this. Even in kingdom, I was reading just very quick. When I went in assemblies of God, I was leading from in a church, youth in a church. And I was chosen to lead in a, I don't know how the denomination, how they could do. And I was chosen even to read in the city of Kigali, leading assemblies of God youth. Hallelujah. So in 2006, God, just by His grace, because He directs your feet, and I got a job in the President's office. And I was working, hallelujah. I was working with excellence. And when I'm working there, I also started lunch hour prayer. I went when God has called you in a great places, don't hide your Christianity.
Life.
I went and requested myself. We need, because sometimes we don't go to ranch. Can you give us 1 day or 2 days in a week? We just have few minutes, those who desire to pray. And they gave me the place. Hallelujah.
And we started
lunch hour in my office. In the office I was working in, Department of Finance, I requested the Director of Finance and Administration that can we pray before we start the work. And they allowed me, after 1 year I'm in President's office, they allowed me, we could pray 10 to 15 minutes before the work starts. Hallelujah.
When I started, we started
when we are three in that department. And
they
started joining. Until all the people in the department, born again and not born again, they could come and pray with us. And they would request me to pray for them. Glory to God. So when you are a child of God, and you see God is calling you in leadership, stand strong and keep your identity. God will use you everywhere. Hallelujah. I went after some years, I went in South Africa to study. I got a scholarship. And I started also reading the Hallelujah. I did 4 years when I'm a mother. Hallelujah. Leading at school, leading at church. Don't say that, you know, I can't be a politician. They have too much work.
Yes.
I could do many things, but I could also excel in a class. Hallelujah. I was a mother.
Mama.
I was pregnant. In 4 years, I went with two children. When I'm doing a degree for 4 years, I also got two children. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I was a mother.
Mama.
I was leading in the department of Christian at school. And I also was advisor among the prefects of the school. Hallelujah. I did my 4 years and I finished 4 years without a SAP. I didn't do SAP in all my studies. Hallelujah. And I was serving God. So when I finished, I immediately got a job. That's where I'm going to end. Hallelujah. And from there, God was promoting me. I don't know how I can explain. Like every 3 months. Because I was serving him. So I went back in leadership, which I want to tell you that you can lead and you can serve God. So I was a country manager after just 1 year in my company. And after I finished the studies, I was ordained as a pastor in 2012. So 2013, I was a pastor also working. Hallelujah. And I was elected again. Now, my nation's, you know, diaspora, I was also requested to lead Women League, they call Commission of Women in South Africa. Diaspora in South Africa.
And I South Africa.
In 2000, diaspora, muri ya wabagore, muri diaspora. Hallelujah. Muri kamivuga mu Kinyarwanda, maybe kujya ngo fata umwanya. Muri mu 2014 o 13 natowe mukuri kuyobora diaspora yabagore, kuyobora ndi muri committee ya diaspora muri South Africa. Ha mu 2014 mera ko ndi mu rwanto rwo kuyobora abagore ba diaspora muri SADC 9 countries. And I was leading diaspora. When I'm in, it's something which also give nibwo bikora ni twatwitanga dukorera igihugu ntago nakuvuga ngo ubuhembwa niki ari kubikora n'ubushake. So nibi nabyo bifite akazi gakomeye cyane. So I was now overseeing diaspora women league in SADC, and I was doing it when I'm a wife, I'm a mother, I love my children, I'm a pastor, I'm working at the in the corporate, nyikora muri corporate nyifite akazi mvuga mu Kinyarwanda. Thank you. Urumva nakoraga ndi umushumba kandi ndi umugore, ndi umumama, nkunda abana banje n'umugabo wanje, ndi umubyeyi, nkunda urugo. Nkunda urugo sinabibabwiye, ariko nkunda urugo nicyo kintu cya mbere. My husband is the first priority and my children. hanyuma nkora nkora muri company nkoramo nari impagarikiye company mu rwego rw'igihugu. So I could travel many times. Ugasanga rimwe muri weekend nkanyuma weekend byiringiye mu kindi gihugu nyuma yo gose bundi ndaho ngaho mu gihugu ndazunguruka akandi nkorera Imana. I was not only serving God. Niyo mpamvu babwira ngo you wemere Imana ira stretching iragukoresha mu buryo butandukanye. Ubwo nakoreraga Imana ntago nakoraga muri department yoroshye nari umuyobozi w'abanyamasenge. And I could preach many times, and God gave me grace to do that. So ndabikora muri 2016 nza hano muri National Dialogue nje kubera kuvuga no kugira ishyaka ryo gukora igihugu n'iki sinzi harimo ibintu byari abantu bakurikirana gusoma hari igihe ibintu bitari meze neza muri diaspora. So icyo gihe turaza ntoranywamo kubera kwa kundi kugira ishyaka ryo gukora kandi ukorana umutima mwiza ntoranywamo mu bantu baza gushira ibintu mu buryo mu mahoro I don't know in Kenya. Yes muri gahunda yes azajya mfasha ikinyarwanda ninyibura muri gahunda muri diaspora. So ndaza turicara turavuga so ndavuga mvuze baramfasha haleluya bagiye kujya gutora a constructive committee aba bakurikirana barabireba bari kuvuga ati ntago turi gushyiraho committee nini ariko turashaka abantu bashobora guhagararira ibihugu byose nuza all continents kandi bagashobora gushibiza ku murongo amahoro muri arena ya diaspora. Nimeziko diaspora ni inuzi ikomeye cyane batwita intara ya gatandatu. So we serve the nation. Hallelujah. Amen. So neneho ndicara baratugiye gukora General Assembly barantoranya. Glory to God. Amen. And I was also chosen to be among the leadership executive committee of Rwanda Diaspora Global. Ubu ndi muri committee ya diaspora guhera uwo mwaka wa 2016. Barantora 2017 nibwo twayoboye twari twashyizweho nk'umwaka barangaho ni mwaka ukurikiyeho barongera badusubizaho barongera n'undi mwaka ushize badusubizaho. So ubu ndacyari muri committee ya diaspora executive committee muri diaspora mu rwego rw'isi. I do that, I'm still a pastor. Hallelujah. I serve God. All the nations I go to serve,
ibihugu byose njyamo,
I live there, I go to serve my nations, but also they call me back to preach the gospel of Christ. I come here when I come for national dialogue, but I also get invited with different churches to preach the gospel of Christ. I still serve my nation. I serve in different positions, but I still serve God. Hallelujah. And I'm still in the fire. I love him than how I loved him more. I still serve him. I still go down and cry. Those things, those titles, they don't mean anything in my life. Hallelujah. I still love him and serve him. So it is possible. You can serve God and remain faithful to him. And also serve your nation in any position. Hallelujah. We need faithful, righteous people in the government. May God honor you. May God give you grace. May God direct you. May God give you positions. May God promote you. May God you give wisdom. May he expand you and do the will of God. In Jesus' name, hallelujah.